Today, we'll understand what are the types of relative experts available. There are different types to write your relative expert. So in that, what are the types that we have? Okay. So for that, first one, let me categorize simple expert, right? So where you are going to identify only a unique element with help of some attributes. Second one, we call it as function notated XPaths. So these function notated XPaths are going to be called as JavaScript methods. JavaScript methods. So what are those functions that are available for me? Where I am going to use this function notated XPath? Suppose when your elements are going to be dynamic in nature with their attributes, property values, right? In such cases, we are going to be use your function notated XPaths. So what are the function notations that are available here? What are the functions that are going to be used in writing your XPath? So first one that I want to bring here is called as starts with. Second one, we call it as contains. Third one, we call it as text. Fourth one, we are going to be called as normalize hyphen space. Next one is going to be called as last not and group. So group we are going to represent with your parentheses. So all these five methods are right, they're going to be very much important in writing your function notated XPath. All these methods are going to be available as JavaScript notated XPaths only, because your DOM is going to be interact by JavaScript methodologies only. So we are going to derive these methods from the flavor of your JavaScript. And next one, third category, I'm going to be called it as forward XPath. And fourth one, we're going to be called as backward XPath. Okay. So this both 3 and 4 will come under the category called as XPath access. 3 and 4 will come under the category called as XPath access. So to understand more about this XPath access, right? What you can able to go here is just go to Double3Schools. Just type XPath access here. So you'll be getting the list of XPath access here. Okay, we can able to see the list of XPath access that are available here. So now what I'm trying to do here is, if I keep everything here, right, you guys won't understand what is this ancestor, what is this ancestor ourself, what is meant by attribute. You can't able to understand everything. So what I did to make it to be very simple and understand by the user very easily, right? So I broke down into forward XPath and backward XPath. But these 3 and 4 categories are going to be fall under your XPath access. Now we'll start looking into one by one with a good example and where I'm going to utilize these examples in my project in the real time. We'll check out that. So wait for that. We'll see now.